What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Mike Sasser, Boudoir Photographer in Los Angeles, California, and today we're going to be showing you how to take your Lightroom presets that are on your desktop and adding them to Lightroom Mobile. Intro time. I do almost all of my editing in Lightroom Classic CC, but I know a ton of people who are now using their phones to edit a bunch, and I want to show you guys how to get those presets working. And then I'm going to show you a few tips when using Lightroom Mobile at the end of this video. So be sure to stick around. Now, I edit pretty much exclusively in Adobe Lightroom Classic, which is a problem because the presets don't sync from Lightroom Classic over to mobile. So we need to use this little intermediary. So Adobe has like 17 versions of Lightroom now. I'm not sure what it was that they were thinking. Maybe they just saw Apple making a whole ton of different iPhone sizes and were like, we don't want to miss that train. But basically there's a couple different versions now. So there's Lightroom Classic. That's the one that if you've been shooting for a while, any of the Lightroom 4, 5, 6 original CC, that's what that one is. The next one is just called regular Lightroom CC. That's their like mobile style based platform. And then they've got actually Lightroom Mobile, which goes on the phone. Now this version of Lightroom is free if you have a subscription with Adobe Lightroom. I feel like you guys should take a shot every time I say Lightroom in this video. All right, so let's take a look at this here. So on the left, we've got Lightroom CC. On the right, we've got our more classic Lightroom called Lightroom Classic. And the first thing we're gonna do to get some presets over is let's create a quick preset just so you guys can see how to do that. What we're gonna do is just do like a goofy little orange teal. I saw this in another video and I thought it was ridiculous. So we're done. Beautiful, orangey ready, Lightroom color, perfect. Okay, so we're gonna take this and we are now going to make a new preset. So file, develop, new preset. We're gonna uncheck all, check none, except for the calibration. That's this little calibration tab. And we're gonna call it orangey ready tealy thing. In user presets, create. Okay, so now in our user presets here, we've got an orangey ready tealy thing preset. Beautiful. Now let's check to see if it's on our phone on Lightroom Mobile. We'll select a photo here. We'll go over to presets and we see nothing. No problem. We knew that was gonna happen. The first step it's gonna take to get this preset onto your mobile phone is to export the preset. And actually, you no longer export presets because Lightroom has done all XMP. So what we're gonna do is go to right click and say show in Finder. Beautiful, here it is. Orangey, ready, tealy thing. So what we're gonna do is go over to Lightroom CC. Are you guys taking shots? Go over here, click this button up at the top right. We're gonna click on presets. And again, we don't have it here. So no problem, we can import this preset by clicking this button here, and we are going to import presets. And this is something really cool on Mac. I don't know if you can do this on PC, but you just drag over here. That's fine, Lightroom can access all my stuff. Orangey ready tealy thing import. Okay, see how this user presets just popped up? So let's click on that and boom, look at this. We've got this beautiful, very cool, orangey ready tealy color preset that we can just start applying to everything. Very, very cool. Okay, now I'm gonna actually go in and import my own personal presets, these Eversummer presets. These are a little bit different because these are done with profiles. When you select on one, you now have this portrait profile that you can either introduce more or less of it, kind of like an opaque layer. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go over here and we're gonna click here and say import presets. I'm gonna go to my downloads because this is where these presets are. Import, and then you can see, boom, beautiful Eversummer presets are right here. We will reset this guy again. And then as we go through, we're gonna see all of these different beautiful colors. So the very last thing we have to do to get these presets on our mobile phones is to make sure that we're signed in on our Adobe account on both Lightroom CC and on our mobile phone. So let's go ahead and go Lightroom, preferences. Here we go, Michael Sasser, subscribed. Here's my email address, cloud storage, beautiful. We are gonna do the same on the phone. So let's go here to settings. At the very top, It says Michael Sasser, michael@michaelsasser.com. You are subscribed. So beautiful. So I'm signed in on both. So let's go ahead to one of these photos here of Hannah. Here we'll scroll all the way to the right. Tap presets. Tap on color there. Then you'll be able to see, there we go, Ever Summer by Sasser and the user presets. So let's do this, the orange tealy thing. That looks absolutely horrendous. So let's click X on that. We'll go back to presets. We'll go to Ever Summer. We'll choose skin preset. That looks a lot better. And there you have it. That is how to get your presets from Lightroom Classic all the way over to your mobile phone. Now let's talk about some of the tips that I have for you guys when using your Lightroom Mobile. So the first tip is that if any of your presets have profiles in them, you can just tap on profiles here and then adjust the total amount that preset is applied. You can go way, way, way crazy. You can pull it down. It's basically like an opacity layer in Photoshop. So that's where your presets are. This doesn't just work for, this works for a bunch of what Lightroom already has in it. So if we tap on something like modern, we can do modern 02 and then just see how much this is applied. So it's one of the benefits of using some presets that have profiles. The next thing is for the ability for Lightroom to shoot in DNG. So your default camera app on your phone really only shoots in basically a JPEG. However, as you're shooting, go ahead and tap that camera icon. And then at the very top, you can see DNG there. Probably by default, it's by JPEG. Switch that over to DNG. And then when you take your pictures, you'll be able to hold a ton more detail when you're going through to edit those. So go ahead and do that. Get a little bit more out of your camera. The last little tip is just copy and pasting your settings in Lightroom. It's one of my favorite things to be able to do, especially when you've put together an edit that you like. You just want to copy that to all of the others. So what we're gonna do here is go over to presets and we will choose one of our presets. Skin is totally fine. Check, and then at the top right, you've got these three dots. We're gonna say copy settings. Select the ones that you want. Beautiful. Tap that checkbox in the top right, and then as you swipe over, you just tap those three little dots and then just say paste settings, and it will paste these settings over from preset to preset. So we'll paste the settings here. We'll go over, I shot this a little bit overexposed. We'll tap on light and bring the exposure down. Before and after, before and after. Beautiful. All right, guys, that wraps up the tutorial on getting Lightroom presets from your Lightroom Classic all the way over to your mobile phone. If you guys have any questions on this, leave those in the comments and I will be happy to answer them. We got one more editing video, maybe two coming up for you guys that is going to be a doozy. Do people still say doozy anymore? I don't think so. Probably not since like 1970 something. I'm gonna use it. It's a doozy. It's what it is. I'm not gonna run from that. Get out there and shoot something. Use some presets on your phone and I will see you in the next video.